I'm Dr. Rama Joshi, Director and Head Department of Gynaecology at Fortis Memorial Research Institute, Gurgaon. We have this Department of Gynaecology, which is a dedicated department which is dealing with, rather managing, all the patients diagnosed of gynaecological cancers. That includes the uterine cancer, cervical cancer, ovarian cancer, vagina, and vulva, and also manage all suspicious cases of gynaecological cancers. We also undertake the treatment of the pre-malignant conditions of the gynaecological cancers, as well as we have the preventive as well as the awareness programs being run for the prevention of the possible gynaecological cancers. We have the maximum experience of performing the robot-assisted minimal access surgery in gynaecological cancers in northern India, and I'm the recipient of the National Award for establishing this technology of the robot-assisted surgery in gynaecological cancers in the year 2017. Uterine cancers, I shall be talking to you today about. Uterine cancer is the cancer which arises in the lining of the uterus. And this lining of the uterus is usually shed off during the menstruation and the patient has bleeding, or every woman who is having the menstruation is having bleeding. But when the cancer develops there, this is known as the uterine cancer. This usually occurs in the women of the postmenopausal age group, but this can also occur rarely in the younger women who are of the reproductive age. Most of the time, we see that these women who are suffering with the uterine cancers are obese. They do have the comorbid conditions like diabetes, hypertension. So it is important for us that whenever we are dealing with or we are treating these women of the uterine cancers, we also have to consider that these women are their obesity, their diabetes, as well as other comorbid conditions. Usually the symptoms, the people ask, what are the symptoms of the uterine cancers? Most of the common symptom is that when the woman has the menopause or has achieved the menopause, after that, when the bleeding occurs or any of the spotting occurs, there is likely chance that it can be the uterine cancer. Or sometimes there can be excessive or the irregular bleeding, which may occur even in the reproductive age group. Then also the woman can have the endometrial cancer. This requires to be excluded, though it is comparatively rare in the reproductive age group women. Otherwise, in the postmenopausal age group, even if there is any kind of the blood stain discharge, then also I think one has to exclude the uterine cancer. So these are, I would say that these are the symptoms or the signs which do not cause any difficulty or any, you can say, the discomfort to the woman, or there is no pain. So these are the signs to be known about, and one has to really be, you know, alarmed with these signs and has to go for the checkup. And then exclude that there is no malignancy inside the uterus, that means the uterine cancer. The problem comes, as I said, that these women are obese, they are diabetic. Now you can imagine, if suppose when we are taking up them for surgery, the incision has to be given from the suprapubic region to right, you can say, above the umbilicus in the epigastrium. So it becomes a real challenge because these women are obese and you can say diabetic. Incision related problems are we are facing in number of these patients. And since I have the experience of more than 25 years dedicated to the gynec oncology, I have experienced a lot. And now we have switched on to the robot assisted minimal access surgery. And I'm very happy to share with you that for last more than 3 years, we are doing, you can say, the management with the robot-assisted surgery in gynecological cancers. But of course, the selection of the patients is very, very important. And we can avoid the incision-related morbidity of the patient. It is as safe as that of the open. Rather, it is much more precise. You can say the morbidity is much less in comparison to the open. And our patients are admitted a day before the surgery. And usually our patients are discharged on day two of the surgery after they take the breakfast, or maybe in the day two in the evening. So their overall, you know, the stay in the country also reduces, because usually they fly back to their own country on day seven of the surgery by the time the histopathology is ready. And after the histopathology, we decide whether patient requires any other treatment or not. Any other treatment, adjuvant form, can be the radiation therapy. The different types of radiation therapy are chosen based on the stage of the disease. The minimum treatment can be just the intravaginal radiation therapy. So the patient is really benefited with the minimal access robot assisted surgery, which we are doing in our patients. We are very happy to see them, you know, walking and rather having their breakfast in the morning, and then they basically leave the hospital the day two. So I think this is an advancement in the surgical technique, and this surgical technique has been proven so far as the oncological outcome is concerned, the similar to that of the open surgery, and this is what basically makes us happy to deliver the best to our patients. So for that matter, not only the uterine cancer, but we do robot-assisted surgery in the conditions other than the uterine cancers, but we select the patient after the clinical evaluation. We can do it in the complex ovarian masses or very early suspicious ovarian cancers, or even the very early cervical cancers. Sometimes we have the suspicion of the uterine masses. These patients can also be dealt with very nicely. We can extend them with that of the minimal access robot assisted surgery. So in case if you have any query related with the gynecological cancers or uterine cancers or minimal access robot assisted surgery, you can always write to us and we will answer your query well.